Hi guys, welcome to a fresh new episode of Booksfinity, and today I'm going to discuss about the Da Vinci Code, and I got this in a hardcover edition, which was at a pretty low price that time. It was 700 for a hardcover book. Many of my close friends and my relatives said that you should read the Da Vinci Code, so I gave it a try. This is the fourth book of Dan Brown, and second in the Robert Langdon series. So the series is the chronological manner is something like this. We have Digital Fortis on the first one, we have Deception Point, Angels and Demons, and then the Da Vinci Code. So this is a pretty good book, I'll say, a fascinating read, but it is a controversial thriller. This book is banned in many countries because this book questions Christianity, this book questions Jesus Christ, and many people got offended and they banned the book in the countries. So there are many countries where this book is still banned. So reading a banned book, it was a pretty good experience, to be honest. And somewhat this book will actually bore you in between. So the plot, if you ask me about the plot, I'll give it 3/5. I think Dan Brown's books, he gives a lot of description about anything, and those descriptions are somewhere required for the story to progress. But reading this book, I felt like, oh my god, why is he becoming a history teacher right now and giving me so much of information? Do I have to remember all these? At some point I felt like, oh my god, I am reading my history textbook. But the story after that, the ending was pretty cool. The ending was very suspenseful, so you cannot even guess what will happen at the last. But yeah, it's a full of secret, full of suspense novel. Those kind of stuffs are there in this, and I'll recommend that everyone who is above the age of 16 or 17 should read this book, because this book actually has some 18 plus graphic content in the book itself. Moving forward. So Robert Langdon, who is a symbologist, is invited, and the one he's going to meet in the evening is murdered, and that person writes down PS, that is postscript, find Robert Langdon. And that is how the story progresses, and it is just amazing. People think that Robert Langdon is the murderer, but he has not done anything. So that is one point, but I'm not going to give you any more spoilers. So this was not a spoiler, this is just a main basic storyline. And it is Robert Langdon and Sophie, both of them. Sophie is a cryptologist, so for the first time and for the only time, I guess, Dan Brown has introduced a cryptologist in his book. And Sophie, both of them, what they do is they find out secrets which are hidden in Leonardo da Vinci's painting. So this is a very fascinating read, to be honest, but it is controversial, and it may offend you sometimes, but that's the whole story of the book. This book, I have given the link in the description box below. You should go and check it out. But if you are interested in reading a lot of history and a lot of, you are interested in France and the history of France and all those things, you should read this book. Otherwise, do not read this book. If you don't read this book, please do read Angels and Demons. That's not a controversial book, but this one is a bit controversial. So there's a film as well, The Da Vinci Code, same name. They released a film on Da Vinci Code, then they released a film on Angels and Demons. The story has been a bit changed in the film, but the film is actually, if you haven't read the book, you won't get anything in the film. So please do not watch the film first. I am actually giving you a warning. It's not because I'm encouraging people to read books, but still, I am warning you that you won't understand anything. And people do generally is they go on watching the film, and after they have watched the film, they don't like it, they won't read the book. So I'll say that if you are planning to watch the film or read the book, please read the book first, then watch the film. That would be pretty good. And if you have read this book, do tell me your views, your opinions. Maybe my opinions will not match your opinions, but maybe, yeah, you can tell me in the comment section that if you have read Da Vinci Code, I give you this opportunity to rate this book out of 5. So the viewers who are watching Da Vinci Code, I mean, who are watching this video and who have read Da Vinci Code, do rate this book in the comment sections. Let me know your views on this. And we'll meet next Sunday. We'll discuss about the third book in the series, that is The Lost Symbol by Dan Brown. So till then, bye-bye.